stand, please. Danielle is now coming forward to light two candles, one in memory of Paul Grant Sr. and one in memory of Paul Grant Jr. We welcome their memory into this service today, and they add to the fullness of this wonderful event. We are gathered here this afternoon for the marital union of Danielle Lynn Grant and Samuel Joseph Harrow. We've gathered to celebrate this event with this dear family. And in so doing, we must remember that we're coming together as family and friends of this dear couple. They have invited you to be a part of this event, so it's special. And it's a special time in the life of Danielle and Sam. And we're glad to be able to be here together for this union of these two lives. Let's bring to it all the joy and the care and the respect that's due to a time like this. Now, who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her parents.
Thank you, George. It is a wonderful time, as I just got through saying. But marriage is not anything to be taken lightly. Now, Sam, Danielle, you already enter this with a great deal of responsibility. And it's important that your friends and family are here, because I'm going to tell you, though, they're not going to be responsible for everything you do. And they certainly can't just do everything for you, because that's why you're coming together as a couple. But this is a family event. Your family worked real hard to make this possible. I've noticed some of your family members have labored just in the preparations of this place here where we are, in the sanctuary, as well as the reception hall. But there have been a lot of other things going on. All the talk and all the, not just preparations, but the whole taking hold of this event, of you coming together. It's important. And so I hope that not only you can appreciate this today, but for many, many years to come, and that you'll work together in the spirit of what family is all about. As a matter of fact, Sam and the groomsmen and I were talking about matters over here in the other building a little bit ago about how our world is shaping today and how people view marriage. And there's a certain type of skepticism and cynicism all around it. We know that. We see things not going the way we'd like for it to go, but yet we are a part of that. So what remedy can we bring to the concern around that? We should bring reality into it. Not merely fairy tale stuff and all that starry-eyed wishing, but reality about responsibility and what true love and real care and togetherness is all about. What it is to hang in there and dig with it in the tough times of life. Because that's what it's about. That's what you two guys are getting ready to enter into. And I tell you what, I wish you well and pray the very best for you. I honestly do. The Lord would love to be the Lord of your home, but only you can make him that. You see, having a Christian-type ceremony or me praying prayers and your family reading scripture, that doesn't make it that way. Only you can make it that way. Only you can say, hey, God, not only do we need your help, we need you. We need you in our hearts and our lives every day. So I'm not getting ready to have an altar call or an evangelistic service here, but think about that. Because if you're going to be able to sustain life, you've got to be able to work with the sustainer who created life and who will help you if you let him. I urge you to do that. So important. So at this time, considering the fact that these two have come together and that we are here in a celebration, but let's be reminded it's also a time of worship, let us pray. O God, our Father, as we continue in this very special moment in the lives of Sam and Danielle and all their friends and family, may you bring such a realness and the availability of the absolute truth of this moment so that we can understand more about what relationship and life and family is all about. Because you ordained that from the beginning. May that be something to sober us in a world of so many challenges that it can be done. And there can be joy. And there can be that togetherness that we think about that can be reality when we follow you. Because you know us so well, may Danielle and Sam know each other and know you in the fullness of all that can be. It is through the Lord Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. We now have scripture readings from two of the extended family members, from 1 Corinthians and from Matthew. If you will come forward now and take your places and have your readings, please.
1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 13. Love is patient, love is kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecies, they will pass away. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became grown, I gave up childish ways. For now I see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I have been fully known. So now faith, hope, and love abide. These three, but the greatest of these is love.
I'm reading a couple verses from Matthew 19, verses 4 through 6. Jesus said, "Have ye not read that he who made them from the beginning made them male and female, and said, For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh, so that they are no more two, but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder."
Sam and Danielle are going to have a unity ceremony, mingling sand together, describing the coming together of their lives. Danielle and Sam, I'm going to ask you now to face each other and join right hands, making an agreement. Sam, do you take Danielle to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, till death you do part, according to God's holy ordinance? Do you pledge unto her your faithfulness? If so, will you say, I do?
I do.
Danielle, you take Sam to be your lawfully wedded husband, having to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, till death you do part, according to God's holy ordinance. Do you pledge unto him your faithfulness? If so, will you say, I do? Thank you. Throughout history, the exchange of gifts during a time of a couple coming together has been a tradition that's thousands of years old. We remember the stories about the dowries that were given long ago. But now that's been pretty much symbolized now in the exchange of wedding rings. Danielle and Sam have rings today, and they're going to exchange these as tokens of love for each other, symbols of their commitment. The wedding ring is a circle, symbolizing eternity. Wedding rings are made of precious gold and sometimes encrusted with jewels, which shows the value of their love for one another. Sam, will you now take the ring that you have for Danielle? Would you place it upon the third finger of her left hand? And I want you to repeat after me. Danielle with this ring.
Danielle with this ring.
I pledge my life and love to you.
I pledge my life and love to you.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you. And Danielle, will you now take the ring that you have for Saint? And will you place it upon the third finger of his left hand? And would you repeat after me? Sam, with this ring.
Sam, with this ring.
I pledge my life and love to you.
I pledge my life and love to you.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. In so doing, you're bringing a symbolism of your lives together. Wear those rings as a symbol, proudly, that you belong to each other. At this time, we have more scripture reading from other members of the family. If you would now come forward and be reading from Genesis and Hosea.
I'll be reading from Genesis 2:18-24. And the Lord God said, "It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helpmeet for him." And out of the ground God formed every beast of the field and every bird of the heavens, and brought them unto the man to see what he would call them. And whatsoever the man called every living creature, that was the name thereof. And the man gave names to all cattle, and to the birds of the heavens, and to every beast of the field. But for man there was not found a helpmeet for him. And God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs, and closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the rib which God had taken from the man made he a woman, and brought her unto the man. And the man said, "This is now bone of my bones, and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh."
I'm reading Hosea 2:19-20. "And I will betroth thee unto me forever. Yea, I will betroth thee unto me in righteousness and in judgment, and in loving kindness and in mercies. I will even betroth thee unto me in faithfulness, and thou shalt know the Lord."
See now that before these witnesses, and in the very light of the Holy Scripture, and in accordance with the law of the state of North Carolina, I am glad to pronounce that Danielle and Sam are husband and wife. And as the Scripture says, you have been joined together. Let's help keep them together. Let's pray and do our part. Sam and Danielle, you do your parts. Now let us pray. Now may the Lord bless and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace. May the power of even the very presence of the Lord Jesus Christ be the power that helps you to overcome all challenges as you live and move through life's journey together. Now, I'm asking all of you to turn in your program to the very back. And there's a marriage prayer. And you're going to be led by Bill Brandon. Bill's right here in front of us now. Read along with him this marriage prayer as we conclude this service.
Lord, help Sam and Danielle to remember when they first met and the strong love that grew between them, to work that love into practical things so nothing can divide them. We ask for words spoken kindly.
Amen. Wonderful. Thank you all for that. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is my good pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Sam Herrick. Thank you all for being here. God bless.